See here in this problem, here how to find the damping ratio for the given block diagram. So you observe here, R of S is the input and C of S is the output here. So at the summing point, the forward gain is given as 72 by S square plus 2RS and feedback gain is given as 2. So this is a negative feedback. So we know that transformation means C of S by R of S. So this is forward gain, means G of S, and feedback gain it is H of S. Now in terms of forward gain and feedback gain, the trans function is equal to G of S divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S. So here it is negative feedback, that's why I take here positive. Now substitute forward gain and feedback gain in this formula, then we will get 72 divided by S square plus 2RS divided by 1 plus 72 divided by S square plus 2RS into, so feedback gain is 2. So that's equal to 72 divided by S square plus 2RS upon, so here is S square plus 2RS LCM, that is S square plus 2RS, here S square plus 2RS into 1 plus 72 into 2 means 144. So here these two terms are cancelled and it becomes 72 divided by S square plus 2RS plus 144, and this is the required trans function for the given block diagram. But here we want the damping ratio. We know that standard cat equation, that is S square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square equal to 0. So here from the trans function, the cat equation is S square plus 2RS plus 144 equal to 0. So by comparing these two equations, we get omega n square equal to 144. So that is omega n is natural frequency, that's equal to 2R. Similarly, compare the S coefficients. So from this we get 2 zeta omega n equal to 12. So here omega n we got 12, that's equal to 2 zeta into 12 equal to 12. So that is zeta equal to 1 by 2, nothing but 0.5. So this is the damping ratio for the given block diagram. And this is the process of simplification. And thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share. Thanks.